We think and interact with each other like no other creatures on the planet. But while we like to see ourselves as thoughtful and caring people, it's not always the case. Here are 10 of the most influential social experiments that you'd think would have had different results. Number 10, the Good Samaritan Test. If you saw someone in need, do you think you'd stop and help them out? What if you were in a hurry? To test this, psychologists at Princeton University designed an experiment in the 1970s. The premise was simple. A group of students were all called to see researchers and asked to give a talk about the Good Samaritan from the Bible at a nearby building. They were either told that they had plenty of time to go to the next place, had a little time, or were running late already. On their way to where they were supposed to give the speech, they would pass a stranger, one that appeared to be sick and needed help. Because of the route they took, there was no way that the students would be able to pass the stranger without noticing him. Now, how many of the students do you think stopped to help the man? Even though that they were giving a speech on the Good Samaritan, the time pressure had the biggest impact. 63% of those with plenty of time helped, 45% of those with a little time helped, and only 10% of those who were running late helped. These are much lower numbers than the experimenters expected. What do you think you would have done? Number 9, the Majority Rule Experiment. Do you have a mind of your own, or are you more likely to conform to fit in with others? In 1951, Solomon Asch designed an experiment to test this. He took 8 people into a room and gave them a vision test. They were shown 3 lines of different lengths and asked which one was the same length as the 4th line that was shown. Now, 7 of the 8 people being asked were actors, and only the 8th was a true participant. The actors had all agreed in advance the wrong answer to give, and they were asked, one by one, to give their answer out loud. This was repeated a number of times with each participant. Across the study, about 3/4 of participants conformed with the wrong answer at least once, and in total, 32% of answers given by participants were wrong, in line with what the actors had said. This raises an important question. When people make decisions in groups in real life, over politics for example, how many are making their true decision, and how many are simply going with the majority? Number 8, the Hawthorne Effect. Sometimes, the only way we can further understand ourselves is by experimenting on people. The rules surrounding this have changed significantly in the past century, and it's no longer considered ethical to put people in traumatic situations or conduct experiments on people without their prior permission. This has caused an issue, known as the Hawthorne Effect, whereby people's reactions when they're being watched are different when they would be otherwise. The effect was first noticed in the late 20s and early 30s on a factory floor in Hawthorne. Researchers wanted to see if increasing the lighting would improve productivity, but were surprised to learn that, while it did, the same improvement happened when the lighting was reduced. In fact, any changes they made, whether good or bad, actually improved productivity. And the researchers realized that it was the fact that someone was concerned enough about productivity to conduct research on it that made the workers work harder. Number 7, the Value of Art Experiment. Why is a piece of art worth what it is? How much would you pay for a bottle of wine or to hear your favorite musician? In 2007, the Washington Post carried out an experiment that shows how our sense of value is affected by the packaging. Joshua Bell is a highly regarded violinist, and in the week of this experiment, he had sold out Boston's Symphony Hall with seats selling for an average of $100. The question was, if he played with the same skill and the same $3.5 million violin at the metro station in L'Enfant Plaza in Washington, how many people would stop to listen and how much would he make in donations? What do you think happened? Would people stop and appreciate the music? Well, of course they didn't. Despite playing a long set, and one that was arguably better than he had performed at the sold-out show a few days earlier, out of the 1,097 people that walked past him during the 43 minutes he was playing, only a handful stopped to listen. And how much do you think he earned during this? A grand total of $32.17. Number 6. The Stanford Prison Experiment. The Stanford Prison Experiment is one of the most famous psychological tests of all time, and looked at how readily people would conform to roles in society. They wanted to understand if recent reports of brutality by prison guards was as a result of their sadistic personalities, or because of the prison environment itself. In 1973, researchers, led by Philip Zimbardo, created a mock prison in the basement of a Stanford building. They signed up a group of participants and randomly split them into 2 groups, prisoners and guards, before putting them into the prison. The results of this experiment were a surprise to everyone involved, and have informed prison design ever since. The participants fell into their roles very easily, and the guards began to harass the prisoners within a few hours, despite fully knowing that they were participants too. The prisoners too fell into typical behaviors, and confrontations between the 2 groups escalated. The experiment was meant to last for 2 weeks, but they had to cut it short at 6 days because of the severe effects. prisoners became ill, guards came up with harsher punishments, and even the lead researcher said he began to feel like a prison superintendent and not a researcher. Both the guards and the prisoners internalized their roles as part of their identity. It just goes to show that our behavior can easily be shaped by our environment and institutions. Still, as we've learned by the Hawthorne effect, they may have acted this way because they knew they were being watched. Number 5. Altered memories. How much do you trust your own memory? Elizabeth Loftus wanted to look at the permanence of memory in 1974, and in particular, investigated the reliability of eyewitness testimony. To do this, she showed 7 different videos of traffic accidents to 45 different participants. They were then asked to describe what had happened as if they were eyewitnesses, and then asked specific questions, such as, how fast were the cars going when they smashed? When this final question was asked, the word smashed was changed for each participant, by using alternatives such as collided, bumped, hit, and contacted. It's a simple test, but the results showed just how our memories can be changed. The average speed given by participants was directly affected by the verb used in the question. Those who were in the smashed group gave the highest average at 40.8 miles per hour, and those in the contacted group gave the lowest at 31.8 miles per hour. That's a difference of 9 miles per hour simply based on the way the question was asked. It shows how influential words are, and just how important it is to ask non-biased questions. It also shows how the process of recall is just as important to memory as the process of storing it in the first place. Number 4. The bystander effect. If you see someone in trouble in the street, would you go help them? What if there were other bystanders there too? Would you still help, or would you get out your phone and start to record? An experiment in 1968 was conducted to discover what most people would do. Participants were invited to a lab where they had a discussion about personal problems with each other. As part of the experimental design, these discussions were held between the participants over an intercom. It was repeated a series of times, with a different number of total participants used in each. During the conversation, one of the participants, who was an actor, experienced an epileptic fit and called for help, and the researchers timed how long it would take for one of the others to go and offer assistance. Surprisingly, they found a very clear effect based on the total number of people who were in the conversation. The more there were, the longer it took for someone to help. Quite why this bystander effect happens isn't entirely clear, but it's thought to be mainly because of collective responsibility. The more people there are, the more we can expect someone else to help instead of us. So the responsibility is diffused among multiple participants. But if you're aware of it, you can potentially save someone's life. Next time you see something, don't be the person who records it. Be the one who goes to help. Number 3. Jane Elliott's divided class. Racism is a problem faced by societies around the world. But is it a learned behavior or something instinctual? Jane Elliott conducted a controversial experiment in 1968 that attempted to answer this. She was a school teacher, and it was the day after the assassination of Martin Luther King Jr. All of her children were white, but she divided the class by eye color, and then told them that people with blue eyes were smarter, faster, and better than those with brown eyes. She gave the blue-eyed children preferential treatment, and they couldn't even drink from the same water fountain. At first, there was some resistance. But soon the blue-eyed children started to behave arrogantly, bossing around the others, while the brown-eyed children began to behave in a more timid and subservient way. Furthermore, the blue-eyed children's test results improved, and those of the brown-eyed children got worse. This experiment was the first to prove that prejudice is a learned behavior, and that its existence causes massive changes to someone's personality. It's therefore important to counteract these effects, and ensure that everyone, no matter their eye color, truly has the same opportunities from a young age. Number 2. The Milgram Obedience Experiments. In the wake of the atrocities that took place in the Second World War, researchers wanted to prove that there was something different about the German psyche that allowed them to behave in the way they did. Surely not everyone would have been so obedient as the guards in the concentration camps, would they? Stanley Milgram ran possibly the most famous experiment in psychology to find out the answer to this question. He had 2 participants. One was the questioner, who would read out a series of word pairings, and then read out the words one by one and wait for the correct response. The second participant was the responder, and their job was to remember the words and repeat them back. If they got an answer wrong, they would be administered increasing strengths of electric shocks by the first participant. Of course, this was a setup, and the participant being electrocuted was an actor. The idea of the experiment was to see how far the questioner would go and how many electric shocks they would give, no matter how much pain the other person appeared to be in. There was a researcher in the room, and they would tell the participant to continue with the experiment if they showed signs of resistance. You would stop, right? Especially if you were faced with delivering an electric shock that was potentially fatal, right? Well, they found that 65% of people, despite showing signs of stress, went all the way and administered the potentially life-threatening shock. It proved that we're naturally obedient beings, and our ability to attribute blame to others means that we're incredibly capable of horrific things if we're told to do so by a person of authority.
Before I reveal the next example, you should subscribe if you've enjoyed this video. We upload amazing, fact-filled list videos daily. Also, make sure to click that bell icon to stay updated, or you'll regret missing out on some amazing knowledge that could have filled your brain.
Number 1. No pants are the best pants experiment. How observant are you? Would you notice a $50 bill on the sidewalk? Or how about a person whose pants were simply painted onto her body? This experiment looks at how closely people pay attention to one another. As the model walks through the street, only some people she passed notice that something's not right. Some take cheeky pictures, and others simply stare. One thing's for sure, though. Nowhere near as many people realize what's happening as you'd think. It just goes to show that our mental shortcuts mean we're not always fully aware of what's around us. So, how do you think you would have responded if you were participating in these experiments? Were you shocked by the reality they revealed about our human nature? Tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching.